this is kind of part of the haul. So the first thing that I have for the haul is this 3D sleep eye mask. So this was sent to me to purposely review. And if you guys are interested in this, I actually get a discount code. I believe that they said that I would get like a commission if you guys bought it. But I want you guys to know that I don't really care about that. I'm very honest with like any reviews that I do. I was actually a little nervous to be receiving like an eye mask because I have sensory issues, so I can't have a lot of stuff kind of covering my face. But I went ahead and said that I would try it. So this is what it looks like. Soft, and then it has like a, like this is the band that goes up the back of your head, and it's like a soft like padding on the back of it. It's not just like the strap on the back of your head. It is pretty comfortable. It does take, I feel like, getting used to have like a something over your eyes, but like I would say after like, excuse me, after about an hour having it on, didn't bother me at all. I will say there is like, so you have like light peeking through or something, you can kind of see some light down by the nose section. I think the point of this is to probably try and block out that light, but with mine I couldn't get it to kind of stay where I wanted it to. So I say that's the only thing I was like I wouldn't even say it was a dislike. It was just like when I was awake I could notice that, but it didn't bother me because I had my eyes closed, you know what I mean? But the reason I was kind of excited though is because I don't have a curtain for my window. So when it's my day off and I sleep in, that light comes on and it's pretty bright in here because that window and then I have like an open doorway that brings in a lot of daylight. I'm so sorry if you hear the AC very loud, but excited to try this out. This does block out literally all that light. I slept in for another 2 hours than what I normally would, because again I get up at like 4 a.m. from work, so I normally sleep in to like about 6 or so. I slept in until 8, like 8:30-ish. So I do recommend this. Like, I think it takes some getting used to like wearing it, but it is really comfortable. It didn't like leave any indentations on my face and it didn't like irritate me. I will say you gotta find like the right spot for the strap. Sometimes I don't know if I have like a weird shaped head or what, but like the strap kept coming on my ear and I have to like tuck it in, but that happened like 2 times, then I fell asleep, so then it didn't bother me obviously because I'm asleep. So but again, here is the discount code, gets you like 20% off. If you guys want to check it out, there will be the link to the like where you can purchase it if you guys are interested in it. And it comes like on the back, like it shows you how to wear it correctly, how to clean it. Says if there's like still light coming in, because like right where I said it's gently pressed on both sides of the nose to adjust the best shading effect. So maybe I just had it adjusted somewhere. I messed with it a little bit, but I gave up because again my eyes are gonna be shut, you know. So that's the first thing that is my haul. And it comes in like a vacuum sealed baggie. I kept all this stuff because I want to show you guys it. And does work pretty good. It's not uncomfortable. And if you have sensory issues like I do, it isn't that noticeable. And it's soft, so it doesn't have a weird texture. It's not like velvety or anything. If you don't like velvet, it's, I don't know, it's like just soft. I don't really know the... I don't think it's like real silk, but it's like silky. So I'm gonna put that aside. So, next up on my haul is this Kirby plush. Now I showed this in a haul actually not too long ago, but I think I did, because I bought it on the 30th anniversary of like celebrating Kirby. But I was cleaning up my car and I found it again. So it's like, I bought it again because I forgot I had it. So I went inside to show it. This is an official plushie. I'm really sorry about the AC, you guys. I try and like wait to film when the AC is not going off, but it's like always going on, so I'm really sorry about that. So now we have a bag of stuff. Some of this is kind of like older stuff and some of this is newer. So I got, this is from the Dollar Tree, I got some like meal prep containers. There's like a mess. I think I got these, no. I don't think that this Dollar Tree had done the $1.25 yet. I'm pretty sure. I think I have the receipt somewhere. But I got, there's two of these. I'm trying to be better about my eating portions, so I thought this would be good to get. And I also want to start packing like snacks or like breakfast to work, because you know, I spend about $5 daily for breakfast and stuff. If I just pack, I wouldn't even have to spend that. You know what I mean? So. Oh, here's the receipt. Oh, no, it was $1.25. Sorry, I'm yawning. I had a very long day. I've tried this lash glue before. It is super good, so this is a repurchase. I lost the other lash glue, or you know, I think I might have gave it to somebody. I can't remember one or the other. And I'm running low on lash glue slash the one lash glue that I have I don't really like. So for $1.25. Is really like looks for Dollar Tree, I will say. I also, you guys, I got some of the stuff I'll show you today, but I went out and got some stuff, right? And there was a Chick-fil-A truck, and I've never had Chick-fil-A. Oh, my glasses. And I've never had Chick-fil-A before, so my friend and I was like, we should go try it. And we did. And I was like kind of expecting not to like it for some reason. I got a chicken sandwich and then fries. That's what I got. And I got some Dunkin' Donuts. So my order is an iced coffee with mocha flavoring and caramel flavoring plus sweet cold foam on top. With cream and sugar. They make, I don't know why, it tastes better as a medium than it does a large, but I wanted a large coffee. But anyways, so I went and tried it, and at first I was like, I'm not really impressed by this, but I kept eating it, and honestly, it's really, really good. I was pretty impressed, to be honest. I really enjoyed it. But we don't have a Chick-fil-A near us. They do the food trucks to see if there'd be, like, a profitable, like, spot for it. So I hope that they put one in nearby. That'd be good. I'd probably go. I really hope that they put in, like, a Cane's nearby. I love Cane's, you guys. It's so good. But here's the lash glue. Everlasting. So I bought that. And I also got myself a pair of lashes. These are a bit different than the lashes I normally wear. They're a bit, like, poofier out in the inner corner. So I want to see how I like them. If I don't like them, like, worst comes to worst, I can put them on the mannequin head that I have. And these are called Wispy Dramatic. Again, by the Ioni 3D UFO Mink Lashes. I think this is the last thing from Dollar Tree, is this, like, flat flashlight. I don't like the texture of this, like, paper and cardboard. So I got this because, number one, I don't have a flashlight. Visual trigger slash cranial nerve exam. Holy shit, I cannot spell that out. So let's see. It's pretty bright, but I love visual triggers. And I also think because it's thin, it's kind of unique. It's also just, in general, not a bad flashlight, I would say. Just kind of sexy that I don't have to, like, but yeah, I got that because I wanted to do that. And also, I needed a bedside flashlight since, you know, we had the tornado the other day. I realized I didn't have, like, flashlights on here. I have, like, candles, but not a flashlight. So this was a necessary purchase, really. And also, for $1.25. Okay, so the rest of this stuff is either from TJ Maxx or Five Below, which I got today. So I'll start with Five Below. So I went because I wanted to look for fidget toys, because I watched ASMR Kitty's Five and Below haul, and she had a green bean popper. Now Jenny ASMR actually gifted me a green bean popper, which I loved, and I played with so much that I actually broke it. And I tried to fix it, and I couldn't fix it, so I had to, unfortunately, toss it because I broke it, and I felt so bad. But I wanted to get another one because it was really relaxing to have. But my Five and Below did not have them. So maybe I'll check out a different one because there's two near me. But that wasn't a big deal. So I was with my friend and we were looking at t-shirts, and he got a t-shirt. So I got a t-shirt. And this is a t-shirt I'd say normally get. But I'm trying to step out of my comfort zone and, like, add some color to my wardrobe. I really only wear like green. Like more earthy tones, and I kind of want to brighten it up a little bit. this is Vincent Van Gogh's like flower painting, just printed on t-shirt. But I thought it was super cute, and this is an extra large, so it fits a little oversized. Surprised myself actually. Normally after work I cannot force myself to do anything. Like once I'm like after work, I don't do shit after work. Like I go to bed basically. But I pushed myself and I went and I hung out with a friend. So and I'm really glad I did. I kind of wish I went to like Goodwill or something too, just to see what they had, but I didn't. So but that's okay. I didn't need to go. I missed something from Dollar Tree, you guys. I'm so sorry. So I picked up this LA Colors contour stick. And this is in the shade medium. So I was gonna see if this is my contour color or not. I think it will work. I really wanna see if I can use contour sticks before I purchase, because I've been really wanting to purchase the Fenty bronzer cheek sticks, and those are a little expensive, so I wanted to make sure I actually like a product like that before I spend that money on it, you know. So I went ahead and bought this. Oh, and I just took the cap off. It doesn't smell too bad. Go ahead and swatch it. I'm not too sure, you guys. It looks kind of a little light. I don't know. I don't have a brush. I don't know. It could work. I don't have a brush, otherwise I'd just try it right now on camera. But I did. And I just dropped it like a dummy. Shoot. That's just my look, to be honest. And I chipped it. We'll see. I'll try it out. Because I'll be doing like a trying out new makeup video soon anyways, because I bought some makeup. So this is, I got this from TJ Maxx, and I got this for $7 basically. And this is a electric milk frother. So I don't really go out and buy coffee much anymore, other than like today, obviously. I make my own homemade coffee, and I like having foam on top. And I also like making lattes. I love lattes. So this is what froths your milk to make lattes and stuff like that. Okay, there's a card in here saying thank you for your purchase. And I get a free one. Looks like it just takes one. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then you just press down on this to turn it on. I'm super excited. Whoa. And this comes off to clean. Just gonna stop taking it off. Or is that just like that? You know, sometimes there are reasons why things are at TJ Maxx, so, you know, you're kind of always taking a chance with some stuff, but yeah, I've been actually looking at these at Amazon for a bit, and when we went, there it was, and I was like, oh my god, I think this is a sign, I have to get it. And sits in there like this. So yeah, just purely battery operated. Froths your milk. So maybe I'll do like a latte making video. I love lattes, you guys. So yeah, I got this. I was really excited to get something like this because I've also been trying to buy stuff for a future apartment. Just getting that stuff kind of ready to go, just so I'm not spending like a fuck ton of money. When I eventually can afford that. And then I also got from TJ Maxx for $10 is a radiant rechargeable shaver, which I've already used. Not very well. So this is supposed to be for your armpits and your legs and stuff, but I'm using it for my face because I don't shave either of those. Well, I occasionally shave my armpits, but I don't really shave it often just because when I shave very often, and also I just like don't care. If you have any tips for getting rid of like discoloration on your armpits, let me know, because I've tried some stuff, like I've tried like oatmeal stuff, and that just has not worked for me. But anyways, this is the Radiant. I love the packaging. I thought this was so cute. I've opened it, obviously. I would turn on, but it is so loud. But it comes with like a cap. And it's like really. I am dropping everything today. I was actually so embarrassed because it was in there. When I was at the store, I kept dropping things that I would like pick up to look at. And I was so embarrassed. Like, my friend was just giggling at me. I was embarrassed, you guys. Like, just kept dropping stuff. But yeah, so this shaver I'm gonna use for my face. My hair is growing in, like facial hair is growing in, but very, very uneven and bad looking. I'm not shaving my mustache, you can barely see it. I'm so blonde, it's crazy. You guys can barely see my arm hair either. I'm hairy, it's just you can't see it on camera. But my like beard hair, like there were pieces that were like this long. The rest was like stubble, so I was like, no, I'm shaving that. It looks disgusting, and I feel disgusting when I look at it. So I shave that, but I'm not shaving my mustache because I'm trying to see if it will darken or not if I just leave it alone. And you can't really tell, especially kind of farther away. So I'm not really worried about what people say, because I also wear a mask when I'm in public because people are disgusting. Sorry, but like they are. Like the one time that I tried to not wear a mask at work, somebody coughed on me, and I was like, fuck no. Also comes with, I dropped the packaging, so I have to bend over and grab it. It also comes with like this tiny little brush here. I think that's for cleaning off the razor itself. Oh, this smells really good. So, that either is going to sound super good. But yeah. that's for cleaning the razor. But I'm probably gonna keep it all in like the little packaging just so I can make sure like it, I don't lose everything like that and drop it. I'm just gonna keep it down there for now. But I got that, and then here's the last thing that I bought at TJ Maxx for $7. I was gonna buy these two Morphe palettes because they were really great condition and they're only like $5. And I was like, that's a steal for Morphe. But then I saw this one and I just had to have it. It's a palette called Summer Days by Cara Beauty. Now, I've never heard of this brand before, but the packaging kind of sold me. I mean, that just looks so cool. And I'm taking. The boys are fighting. I'm taking kind of a risk with this because this was glued, so I can't check the, I didn't check the inside to see if the shades were broken or not. So I'm hoping that these shades are in good condition because I'll be very sad if not. Because I mean, worst comes to worst, I can probably press the shades back into. The packaging the actual palette looks like. Okay, so it's the same thing. I'm nervous that I want it to be messed up. Ew. Okay. Shit. Whoa. This was, I should have got the other one. There was two of these. There was this one. And then there was like a purple red one, and I almost got both of them, but I was like, no, I don't need both. Just pick one. So this is the one I picked. Look at that. It's in really good condition. There is some staining, but that could have been from me opening it because, yeah. And I think the reason that this is in here is the printing of the names. It's a little off. It's not scented, it just doesn't smell bad. I love this. I cannot wait to use this. Oh my god. I cannot wait. Again, this is by Cara Beauty called Summer Days. Oh my god. If I have a chance to go back to TJ Maxx and that other palette is there, I will buy that shit so quick. Gorgeous. Oh my god, it is gorgeous. I'm super excited about this blue here. That's a gorgeous blue. And this yellow. I don't have any yellow shades. I don't think I have any yellow shades. So I really am excited about this. I'm so excited that worked out. Yes. Ooh, it feels good. It's like, it's very smooth and some, it's like, the, it's very textured. I really like this. I'm going to look them up. It's cruelty-free, paraben-free, so I'm gonna just have to, like, this is a gorgeous palette, you guys, holy shit. Just look at those. Wow, the camera really isn't doing them justice. I'm glad I took a risk on this. So, and then I have to admit something. They have these like compact Hello Kitties, like that are like mirrors and that they like light up when you open them. And every time I go there, I see it. I want it. And they're only like 15 bucks, which really is not bad because I think they're normally like 40 or something like that. But I never, like every time I like see something, I'm like, I don't need it. Maybe when I go to TJ Maxx again, I'll get the Hello Kitty thing and I'll get the other palette if I can find it. If not, I'm gonna find it online because holy shit, that is so. This is gorgeous. I'm so glad to add this to my collection. But you guys, that is all I have for my haul today. I hope that you guys enjoyed and found this relaxing. If you do, just let me know. And let me know if you guys are going to try out this sleep mask. Where did I put it? Again, I do recommend it. It's not a big deal, you know, to me personally. If you go get this or not, I don't care. I just want to let you guys know because, again, somebody reached out.